I concur.
That you, what? Does that mean?
Agree.
Oh, okay. Hey guys! So today I'm here with Sam.
Me!
So today we're going to be doing some directioner pet peeves because there are just so many things that piss us off as directioners, and we came up with a list of top 20 things that piss us off.
And if you have any pet peeves that we didn't mention, leave them down in the comments.
So the first thing, non-fans trying to tell us news that we already know. Like, hey,
that was Irish.
Really?
Really, I didn't know that. Thanks for telling me. I'll write that in my book of One Direction facts that I never knew.
Oh wait, it's already there.
When people hate on them for no reason. No. They worked so hard to get where they are now, so why hate on them? Like, you're probably just jealous.
I mean, if you did all that work, would you want people hating on you?
Yeah, exactly.
Because you're rich and famous?
Didn't think so.
When people think they're better than you because they have more merch.
Nope.
Like, as long as you support them, it doesn't matter how much merch you have. You could have, like, a CD and that's it, and you could still be a bigger fan than someone that has, like, everything. Because it doesn't matter how much merch you have.
A poor man is so much richer than a rich man in love.
You feel
well said.
Thanks. Okay.
When people only like one of them.
Or nah.
You don't like One Direction, you like Harry Styles. You're not a directioner. You have to like all of them, like equally. I mean, you could have a favorite, but like you have to like all of them. You feel?
I feel.
Double-sided posters.
Let's just take a minute on that. I can't.
That's why I like took all of my posters down. Like there's some posters that wouldn't hang up because I wouldn't be able to choose which side to put it on. Or I'd like buy the magazine twice so I'd have like both posters, like put one on one side, one on the other side. Cause like double-sided posters is just a no. Stupid facts in magazines. That goes along with the first one we said, but like when they say like Niall's Irish, just stupid facts we already know that's like plain and simple. Just stupid. When people call them gay, it goes along with hating on them, but
hey, they're gay cause they're happy. Happy means gay, right?
Yeah. Like they're not gay. Like, I know this is like an old joke, and be like, oh yeah, they're so gay for each other. No, they're not. Like, more than half of them have girlfriends.
They're like brothers.
Yeah, they're like brothers. Like, they love each other like brothers. They're not anything more than that. Fans not giving them privacy.
Hey guys, I just figured out where Niall lives. Let's go stalk him in the middle of the night.
Oh my gosh, yes.
No.
Even Liam tweeted one time about how people were knocking on his door in the middle of the night. Like, yeah, if I knew where Liam lived, I'd probably go by there some. But not during the night. I just respect his privacy because you wouldn't want people doing that to you, so don't do that to them. When fans that don't even try hard get a follow from them on Twitter. I know some fans will like literally tweet them all day. Some of them will like maybe tweet them once, but like not even tweet them at all and just get a random follow. It's like, oh hey, not fair. Pisses me off.
Life's not fair.
I know, but still, pisses me off. Niall and Louis are just as important.
The band is not Harry. Harry is not a band.
They're
all important.
Yeah.
Like, I think it's stupid that Niall and Louis get less solos because...
Yeah, like, the last tour they got, you turned down their mics lower. That is not fair. They're all... Five of them are equal. They should be treated equal.
Can't be a band without one of them.
Yeah.
Five guys.
Not four, or three, or two, or one.
Five.
When fake fans get concert tickets. Like, front row tickets, too.
Like Wendy.
And like, yeah. And like, the really dedicated directioners won't even get good tickets at all. They'll get like really high up. Because that's be all that's left when all the fake fans get
there. Or not a.
Front row. Yeah, or none at all. There's a lot of fans that really deserve tickets and they don't get any because they're all sold out. Because all the fake fans get them. That pisses me off. When the media tries to say that Harry is the most important. And then, like, you see Harry in the media the most and like, not the other four guys. Like, what's up with that? When people pronounce their names wrong.
Hey, did you hear about Louis?
It's Louis.
No, it's Louis.
It's Louis. And like Zayn Malik? It's Malik. I mean, I know this is like pretty old, but like almost everyone knows their names now, hopefully, but still. People that don't? Pisses me off. When magazines use old pictures, old fetus pictures, like more than once.
In like 3027, they're gonna be using the photos from the What Makes You Beautiful photo shoot.
Yeah, for reals. That's why I don't even get magazines anymore, because like there's never new pictures.
Jinx, you owe me a soda.
No.
Go get up and go get me a soda.
When people say that they have a least favorite, You can have a favorite.
Who do you think you are?
But get the out. Rest of them are Walk. Equal. Like, you can't have
You know what? You better run because I'm gonna kill you.
Get out.
I'm dead now.
When people think the boys are like 12.
Or when people think all their fans are like 12.
Yeah. They have like, I mean, I know they have lots of young fans. They have older fans too. They probably have fans that are like older than them. They're probably
Exhibit
like moms.
A.
Yeah, Exhibit A right here. And like moms could be fans of them too. Like,
or dads.
You never know. The cougar moms out there. And then like the boys, they're obviously in their 20s. And like, have you seen the facial hair? 12-year-olds don't have facial hair.
Well, they could, but that'd be weird.
When fans call other fans carrots just because they use an old joke in there once or something like that. Like, I get called a carrot all the time, and it pisses me off because,
like, obviously not a carrot.
Everyone's gonna use old jokes every now and then because they're still funny. They might be stupid and old, but like, they're still always gonna be funny and they're still always gonna be there, so they're gonna come up sometimes. But that doesn't mean you call other people carrots because
they use them.
They used them like once, maybe. So, yeah. When people go overboard on Larry.
No.
They're a bromance. I know some people ship them as romance, but if you do, keep that to yourself because,
they would have already come out and said it.
Yeah. If it was true, they would have already come out and said it. So if you want to ship it, keep it to yourself because, I know they've, like, gotten really mad about it on Twitter and stuff. So just keep it to yourself if you're going to ship it. When people hate on their girlfriends.
You mean hating on your boyfriend, girlfriend?
Mm-mm. They make them happy, and I think that's all that matters. So I'm not gonna hate on them unless they're like cheating on them or something, or they aren't happy in their relationship. But they're happy in their relationship, so don't just leave them alone. Don't hate on them. Just let them be happy.
It's their life.
Yeah, not yours. And last but not least, management. And we can talk about that for hours. But literally, management, I think, controls them so much, and it pisses me off so much. So, okay, well, that's a list of 20 things that piss us off. If you agree with us, tell us in the comments down below, and if you...
Or give us a thumbs up.
Yeah, give it a thumbs up as well. Again, if you can think of anything else that pisses you off, then leave them in the comments down below, and I'll probably agree with them. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!
Deuces!